There we go. Good evening. For those of you who don't know me, I'm the Reverend Elise Hanley. I'm the Associate Rector here at the Church of the Epiphany. And on behalf of our interim rector, Father Roy Cole, I'm delighted to welcome all of you here in person, as well as those who are viewing the live stream for our final celebration and farewell to our organ after nearly 60 years of service to our parish. Tomorrow begins its disassembly from this space and its transition to its new home at St. Bernadette's Roman Catholic Church in Scottsdale, Arizona. Meanwhile, our parish community looks forward to our move just down the block to our new home at 351 East 74th Street with a newly commissioned Bigelow tracker organ to be installed in 2023, God willing. Before we get to the program this evening, I want to just go over some brief logistics, especially for those of you who are new to our space. Should you need a restroom, an all-gender, single-use restroom is located off the parish office hallway, which is accessible via the double doors to my right. Following tonight's program, thanks to our vestry member, Stacy Gutman, and her family, all are invited to stay for a brief toast with some light refreshments in the back of the church. And in the garden, weather permitting, we do ask, please, that you utilize the full space for distancing as you stay. And then finally, three, please hold your applause until the end of tonight's program. I am honored to introduce our organist this evening, Stephen Rapp. His full bio is in your program, but I will share some highlights. Stephen is presently serving as organ consultant for our new Bigelow organ. He is also the music director and organist at Our Lady of Mount Carmel in the Bronx's Little Italy. He has held positions at Episcopal and Lutheran parishes in Westchester and Fairfield counties. Stephen has performed as a soloist and collaborator in Europe, Bolivia, and Japan, as well as all over the United States. And the New York Times has praised him for a sterling performance. So we are so pleased to have him here tonight. Again, welcome, and thank you for being with us.
Thank you for observing the no applause. It's a wonderful piece, I think, to begin a recital, this Mendelssohn Sonata, but because it ends quietly after this rousing beginning, it's very tempting to want to gush forth with applause, but it would actually sort of spoil the whole spirit of the mood of it. I let people know about this program, many people who aren't in New York, and I was reminded when I chose this piece that the second quiet movement was my mother's favorite organ piece. Her comment to me after hearing me play many times was, you know, I wish you would play something that had a melody to it. And it's her Italian background had that come out. So anyway, so we're going to hear a lot of tunes coming up, actually. I'm going to keep that sort of request. And we're going to hear four spiritual preludes by a wonderful New Yorker who's a wonderful organist, composer. He taught at General Theological Seminary for many years doing music there and is currently at Smoky Mary's, as everybody calls the Church of St. Mary's at Times Square. And he's composed a number of pieces and is a great improviser. And I've really fallen in love with these four pieces. And only the first spiritual was not one that I knew. Perhaps you know, Oh, What a Beautiful City. And the reason it gained any fame is an interesting story. It was Pete Seeger's family that had a woman who worked for the family who introduced it to them. And so that's how it developed some fame. Joan Baez has recorded it. And it's a wonderful text from the book of Revelations about the opening of this perfect city in squares with three doors or gates on each side of the square, and ends with this glorious hallelujah. So it's absolutely wonderful. I don't think Go Down Moses or Were You There need any introduction, and nor does Deep River, of course. You'll find his language is very colorful. He's very much into what I call chromatic writing, what musicians would call, where there's a lot of half-step movement underneath in the accompaniment. So it's very expressive style of writing. Moving to Bach, the pieces that I'm playing tonight happen to have all been among the very few that were published during Bach's lifetime. It was very expensive to have your music published. And the first two pieces, I think you'll recognize, particularly the first one, the Wachet auf, Sleepers Wake, for Night is Flying, or Wake Awake, it's translated many different ways. And then the piece after that, you won't recognize the title perhaps, but Lobe den Herrn is Praise to the Lord the Almighty. I put it in parentheses. The text that Bach set was for Advent. And the remarkable thing about these pieces is there are transcriptions that Bach made of movements from his cantatas. So the Wachet auf was originally for tenor, soloist with string accompaniment, or string obbligato, really, it's a major part. And then the Lobe den Herrn is one that he actually didn't, we don't have an example of what that piece was, and maybe it was an original piece, but the others in the set are all from cantatas. The fugue in E flat major, I felt, is a perfect piece because this is kind of a bittersweet moment saying goodbye to an instrument. You know, I've done dedicatory recitals, but I don't think I've ever done a farewell recital, so this is kind of a unique experience. And I often play the E-flat fugue, the St. Anne, you'll recognize the tune. Da, 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 da. Oh God, our help in ages past. So I often play that for funerals, and so when I think of the events that have happened here throughout the life of this instrument, I thought it was an appropriate thing to do. And then the Vidor, I decided you all probably will recognize the toccata at the end. That often gets played for weddings, but also I'm sure your organist had probably played it for Easter when you were here in the church before the pandemic, and I don't know if it maybe even got played this year when you had a streaming service. But in any case, so the adagio I thought you might be interested to hear. It's a symphony of five movements, and the adagio precedes the toccata, and is a beautiful way to hear the string stops on the organ, these beautiful undulating stops with a solo that's actually played by the feet, but in a tenor range rather than in bass notes. So I hope you enjoy this program, and I'll look forward to talking to you afterwards.
I invite you to remain standing in body or spirit and join me in prayer. I invite you to follow along at the bottom of page 2. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Let us pray. O Lord, before whose throne trumpets sound and saints and angels sing the song of Moses and the Lamb, we give you thanks for this organ, which has offered your praise through its music and marked the many seasons, occasions, chances, and changes of our collective lives. May this organ continue in the worship of your temple in its new home, and that with the voice of music, we may always proclaim your praise and tell it abroad through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.